In the past, I've shown a bunch of different ways in which you can use Samsung DeX from your Samsung phone on bigger screens to have better multitasking from a mobile device. So that could be your TV or other portable laptops that I've shown. Well, today I'm gonna try out a new screen, which is a little bit bigger, but it is in your car. So have you ever wanted to use that display that supports Android Auto more fully? So with Android Auto, you can use these custom apps that look great and are nice for driving, but what if you're not driving and you wanna use that screen for better multitasking? Maybe it's playing movies or other things right from your phone without needing to add another display to your car. Well, today we're gonna do that with a new product from Mayton. This is the AutoPro X. They sent this out for me to try out. Let's get started. So starting off inside the box, it comes with everything you need to get started, except for the car that supports Android Auto. You're gonna have to take care of that and getting the Samsung phone. But here we have instruction guide, and then it comes in a few different languages, as well as some mounts so that you could easily mount that in your car. And then it also comes with a full video guide. So depending on what car you have, you may need to use a different cable. So they've provided this USB-A to USB-A to USB-A cable, so interesting cable there. Here is the AutoPro X, so nice little puck design on it. All it has is a USB-C and a light, and then a button. Right there on the X is a button, so that's kind of nice. And then inside here, we do have another USB-C to USB-A cable, so this is most likely what will be used in my car. And that's just a tiny little cable, so you'll plug this in, and that's all you need to do, and this should be wireless directly to your phone. And then here we have one more cable, so if you have a car that has USB-C, then you would use this from your car to your phone. So very simple, that's all you get in the box. But then the next thing you need to do is head to the Play Store and download the AutoPro X app. So I have that downloaded right here. We will need to allow for permissions, tap allow, and then here we will need to allow AutoPro X to be able to appear on top. And now here in the app, it's searching for a device. So let's head to the car, get it plugged in and set up. Here in the car, first thing I'm going to do is unplug my other Android Auto cable I've been using, and then I'm just going to plug in this cable. So I am in a Honda, that's the instructions I'm using. Here I have the AutoPro X right there, just sitting wirelessly. It's now plugged in, let's go ahead and turn on the car. Okay, the car has turned on, this is booted up. Now here it's saying that I'm connected to the Bluetooth of the S25 Ultra. Should I allow it to connect to the AutoPro X? I'm just going to tap continue for now, and there it has booted up. Now, it didn't happen that way the first time. This is after like an hour of troubleshooting, it finally popped up. But here we have two options. We have the option to use the AutoPro X with DeX, or we have the option to choose Android Auto. So the great thing is this is a touchscreen interface, so we can easily adjust there. You can even go in here and adjust how AutoPro X is working, touch calibration. You can do the basic mode at 16:9 where it's actually going to be squished, or we can do the full screen mode. So we're gonna keep it the full screen mode. Now here in the AutoPro X app, we want to allow for notifications, and then we're going to search for a device and connect to it. So it just takes a second. And when you connect, it will also tell you if there's an update that's needed. I have had two updates in the last 2 days, so we should be good to go there. So now it's connected. We also have the option in here in the settings to go and set a specific vehicle setting. So depending on what car you have, you may want to come in here and adjust turning this on or off, depending on if it's working or not. But now that everything is working, we also have the option to turn on Auto Connect Android Auto Wireless, so you can do wireless Android Auto. Here we have the option to auto connect back to the AutoPro X, so I'm going to turn that on. Here we need to agree, and then we will need to go to the installed apps and turn on the AutoPro X right there and allow for that to work. Okay, so a lot there. You'll kind of figure it out as you're setting this up, but now we are ready to connect over DeX. So all I need to do is pull this down and go into the DeX option on my Galaxy S25 Ultra here, but I tap on DeX, and is how this is working is AutoPro X is showing up as a wireless DeX device. So I can tap on there. It says we need to turn off Wi-Fi Direct. That's okay. And there, then it began to use DeX over on the screen. So pretty cool right now. Now, one cool thing is usually when I'm using DeX, I'm using it on a monitor where it's not a touchscreen. So I have to go in here and I have to go to the notifications and I have to use the trackpad to navigate around. It's really hard to see the black mouse that I have on there, but it is there. But the cool thing is, this is touchscreen, so you can fully use DeX on here. So if I wanna open up my files, I can tap on there, I have my files. If I wanna open all the apps, I can go on there. Now it is very small touch piece there, but I can go and open different apps. If I want to open a specific app, just like Samsung DeX, it works the same. We can drag and we can have things be split one way or the other. So I can check on my home here. If I want to then close that app, I can do that. And let's go ahead and open Maps, because of course we want to navigate. Now, if I haven't said it already, don't use this while driving. Okay, so now we are going to open Maps in Google. There we have Maps. So I can put it on this side of the screen. So Maps is faster, cool. And I know this is gonna be blurred. You can't really see what that is, but we have Google Maps. You can navigate, you can do all kinds of things all right there within this interface. So it's really cool that I have the option to go right in here and control it and utilize what is happening, or I can then also go to the Android Auto interface. Now, one thing is on the AutoPro X device, there is a button on there. So if I push that button, that is actually a back button from what I think, or it's changing apps from side to side. When I was originally doing it, it would just go back, but there it changed it from one side or the other. So if you hold down long enough, here it takes us back to the option to use AutoPro X or Android Auto. So let's go ahead and try Android Auto. I do have some errands to run, so let's see if we're able to get Android Auto to connect. This is the one thing that I haven't been able to get working, but they recommended to turn on Bluetooth and it should work. So there's AutoPro X. Let's go ahead and connect to it. We're going to pair. And here in notifications, it's saying that we need to connect on the screen. Oh, with the double tap. There we are. We are connected wirelessly to Android Auto. Okay, that's cool. I love being able to have the options. Clearly, this is a little more easier to use while driving. This can be used while driving because it's a much simpler interface. I can quickly go to music, all that kind of stuff, and navigate very easily. Really cool that we have both those options. All right, let's do some errands, try more about what this can do. Navigate to Costco. All right, I have the groceries. Now I have adjusted this to work with my Pixel 9 Fold Pro. So here I've started it up, it goes to this screen, and I've gone into my Pixel to say automatically connect, but let's go ahead, double tap on Android Auto just to make sure that loads up. Don't know if that really does anything, but there you go. It automatically started playing my music. Everything is there. So even if you don't have a Samsung phone, this could work for you as well. Really cool. Navigate home.
I'm now back home, and let's really check out how we can totally use this to multitask on the go. Now, why would you need to use this? Well, I actually spent a ton of time in my car when I worked for Samsung, funny enough, but while I was with Samsung, I would travel around and drive all over the place, and I lived pretty much in my car. So I can see this being really useful if you have something like that where you have a job, you're constantly in the car. Sometimes you don't want to even pull out a laptop to get some work done. With Samsung DeX on the Android Auto interface, this could be used to really be able to get lots of stuff done quickly without needing to pull out that laptop. So as you've seen Samsung DeX before, it is pretty powerful. There are a lot of things that you can do with it. And I'm gonna show you some ways where you can actually enhance what it can do, as I have shown before. So here, we're gonna open Samsung DeX. We're going to connect here. I have also added a SIM card in my phone so that we shouldn't have any more connection issues. One thing I have also done is I have increased the size of my pointer. So hopefully you can see that a little bit easier. And you know, you may notice some lag. That's just how Samsung DeX works wirelessly, but it works pretty good. Now, I have the phone where I can use the trackpad and I can navigate around it. Works really good. So I can come in here, I can find an app I might want to use. I can take that app, hold it down, and drag it and place it on the home screen. So why would you want to use Samsung DeX? Well, first off, if you're using Android Auto, you can't use any of the multimedia apps. So I wouldn't be able to add YouTube, I couldn't add Netflix, I couldn't watch those on the screen if I'm parked, because you're not supposed to use this while you're driving. And then you can totally customize how this is going to work and really get some stuff done. Okay, here in the Google folder, there we have YouTube, and we can hold that down, pull that up to the top here, and we have YouTube. So let's go ahead, open YouTube, and here it opens small, but we can make it go full screen. And then down here, we have all our different options. We can go home, and now we have the bigger screen right here. And on the trackpad, you can use two fingers to scroll up and down. So really cool. But let's say I find a video I want to watch. Sure, let's go ahead and do this one.
On previous Samsung Galaxy.
So I don't see a mute button, so I can simply turn down or turn off the volume, but I can go up here and I can minimize this. It's a little tricky to do with the phone trackpad, but it does the job. I, of course, like I mentioned before, I can drag it here. I can move it half screen and there we have it going. So then I can go and I can choose another app. Say I want the camera for some reason. Here we can drag the camera over here. And now we are doing two things at once. So here it's showing my recent apps and I have both those apps that I can use all at once. So pretty cool that I have the ability to use YouTube as well as over here, I can use a camera. Let's say something that we might actually use. Let's go ahead and open calendar. So when I open calendar, I can then drag that, move it over here to the side. And there we have two things going on. We're looking at our calendar, seeing what needs to be done. And over on the other side, we have YouTube. Really cool. Now to be a little bit more advanced, we're gonna grab our USB-C hub. So here I have an anchor hub where that's gonna plug in my phone because we're wireless, we can easily do that. And then we can plug in different things. So I have a mouse, keyboard. Now that I have these plugged in, I don't need to be using my phone. And I have my mouse here that I could use. And we can go ahead and begin working. So, you know, whatever you find to be comfortable, I need to use Samsung DeX more. So then there we have all the controls. We have all the mouse controls. We have all of the keyboard controls and everything. And we're doing all of this while we are watching YouTube over here. Pretty epic to be able to do all of that. Now, some of the things that I would do is I could check my emails. I would go to Google Docs. Maybe I need to fill out a document. The experience is like you have on Samsung DeX. Now, it's not laptop fast, but it is functional. It's capable to do multiple things. I love how you have the option to snap the windows to the different side. So it's great. If you are stuck in your car and you want to do some work, I think this is a really great option to use Samsung DeX on without needing to pull out the laptop. Sure, I've pulled out all these other peripherals, but hey, it's pretty cool that it can do all of that right on here. And then anytime I can just come over here and close different apps and so on. Now, if you go into the settings of the device, you then have some other Samsung DeX options. So you can have it automatically start. You can change the font size, the screen zoom. So if you want to increase how much you're seeing, you can do that. And you can change the wallpaper. So this background is kind of weird. Let's go ahead and see what else we got. So there we can change the wallpaper, really make this a little bit more fun. You have options for the taskbar and how that's working, what it's showing, and so on. Let's see, mouse and trackpad. This is where I saw the option to change more settings, and then I could change how big is the pointer and size option. So I could change how big the pointer is. So if I want to go mega big there, we can see how big that pointer is, and I can choose specific colors for this. So it's cool that we really have all these options built right into Samsung DeX, making it more capable to do things. Now, if you do have multiple apps open, all right, so let's say we have messaging app as well as Google Home. Cool. So on the button I mentioned before, you can push the button here. So there we push the button. It takes me to the recent apps. I push the button again. Oh, there it switched to one side. So over here on the right side, it switched it to the left side. Then I can choose to have that app open here. So kind of cool that you have that quick switching over there. There are some keyboard shortcuts you can use to make this even better, but really cool that you have that. And then again, if you are done with Samsung DeX, you can either go into the app on the phone. I can pull down my notifications. So here on the phone, I can tap Samsung DeX is running. And here I have the option to exit DeX. And once I do that, it's gonna take me back to this screen and I could go to Android Auto. And if I want Android Auto to connect from my same phone, I do need to make sure sometimes that you go to Bluetooth, tap AutoPro X, and there we have Android Auto working.
Now, when on Android Auto, you can easily go back to switch between the other Samsung DeX interface by tapping here. I have the Honda button. It's going to take me back here to the main screen, and then I can go over here to AutoPro X. Now, I've also created a Bixby routine where when I connect to DeX, things are going to automatically happen over here. So let's go ahead, turn on DeX. So I had Bixby try and do something, it kind of failed, but anyway, that's okay. So you can go ahead and have automatic things happen sometimes when you do certain action with Bixby routines, kind of a fun thing to do. But again, back here, DeX interface, lots of things that we can do. So there you go. That is how you can use the AutoPro X to have Samsung DeX in your car with your Android Auto interface. Now, really cool that this is able to work with the Samsung phones that are supported, you know, the S25 Ultra, the Flip 7, the Fold 7, and other devices that have used Samsung DeX. So if it's on your device, you'll be able to use it with this. Really cool that I was able to get my other Pixel phone to work with the wireless DeX. I think that's just great to have. And then really nice that I still have the ability to use my USB-C hub and have all the different features on DeX. So if you have any further questions about this or Samsung DeX, please let me know down in the comments below, and I'll leave a link to this down in the description that you can pick up today. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.